we've just been getting to it, like, and working out a lot, working on our game.
I want to make it. He want to make it. So we just pushing each other. He going to take it. So I'm going to take my route. I'm going to just meet him at the top. Told me this to come up. I'm from where them killers are running. But I was never about that. I just worked to the sun of all, yeah. Claiming that they got it over there. But they never had it over there. It's the come up. Come up.
Came a long way, this to come up. Come up. Having somebody practice like that, that's like motivation for real. Cause both of y'all like top tier in the state. So having him next to you is like pushing you to go further, right?
Yeah, cause we always competing, cause we both don't like losing. So yeah, and it's like my best friend, so we just push each other. Cause we both wanna make it, we wanna see each other make it. So we just push each other, motivate each other, and don't let each other slack neither.
Kind of crazy out here sometimes. My family on my back, my people that be coming up with me, trying to get them out the hood with me. So it's like, it's a business right now. So, like, late nights we grinding, like, everybody sleep, we out running, like, we getting it in. Like, things nobody else doing, like, trying to make it out, man. Ain't no joke. Facts.
Talk about what it means to you and your team losing Kayvon for the season.
It's a gift and a curse at the same time. Losing him, that's like a big blow. He was our leading scorer last year. He brought a lot of passion to the team. And, you know, it's just good to have him. But without him, I think we can still win, still do really good. But some people just got to step up. We got a lot of big men that was okay last year that didn't really get a chance because he was there. And I think they're going to step up this year. And it should be all right this year. I think we're going to be good.
John Shelton, Coach Shelton, Sean, coach and teacher. I was a teacher in fifth grade. And that's when we spent a lot of time together. I used to have him and Famir both in the same class. And they used to compete on everything. They would come from the weekends, from their tournaments, and bring their trophies in and say, "You got MVP, I won this tournament, I won this tournament." And they both always had that competitive drive, so you knew that they were going to be something. So sixth grade year, I said, you know, I'm going to take a shot on having me the point guard. And I rarely have a sixth grade point guard, which means I'm going to have him for 3 years, sixth, seventh, eighth grade. And I got a chance to see his growth. One thing, you know, I always say to him, you know, his game would always evolve, but I needed his mind, his attitude. And it was a struggle at times, but year after year, you've seen improvement. And, I really think he made a jump after he left Thomas Edison, because he knew that, okay, now I'm on my own, now I'm gonna have to go to that next level. I'm going to high school now, I'm gonna start back at the bottom in ninth grade. And he really took the challenge head on. And his drive, his work ethic, it was just a joy to see. And, you know, I try to come to every game that I can. And I'm proud of Famir too. Famir left, he went to Stan, came back, and mount and seen these guys play and do the things they're doing. Just proud of them. They always tell me that they're gonna be something. It's all about years, it's about working hard, and it's dedication to the game. And that's something that they've shown, that he's shown. That's where he's at, that's why he's at the point that he's at now. That I just wish nothing but the best for him. I try to do everything I can to help these guys. But they're gonna be something special. And they keep working the way that they keep doing what they're doing, and working at the level they're working now. I think there's no doubt that we're going to be hearing their name for a long time. I think they're going to be special. Who would have thought we would make it this far? Times they was hard and we had to move hard. Who would have thought we would make it this far?
Talk about going from unknown, because it was one day where people didn't know who Famir Ali was. Talk about those days, and talk about the days now that everybody knows your name wherever you go.
When I was at Sal's, I didn't really get that much tick like that. I wasn't that hype man that people wanted to see. But going into 10th, and now I'm grade going to my 11th grade year, it's totally different. I can walk around and be around places, and the little kids will come up to me and stuff, and they show mad love. It's like me and Bones. Like, that's who everybody talk about now. It's just me and him. Where I'm from, everybody in the hood come up to me and they show love. It's like we the city's favorite. That's all it is.
Yo, what you doing, bro?
Man, looking for a workout. Cool with Major Key, man. You know the power of you, bro. Words to Major Key.
You ain't getting no check from him.
Come on. Going to sponsor me, too.
Oh, I'm that man.
That's some fucking crazy as shit. And some Mambas. Some Mambas.
Nah, not some Mambas, matter of fact. Two of them. Feels good to be in the city, man. Word. My city. Big things coming, bro. Big things.
So I'm going to the gyms. I'm not getting picked up. Yo, so what I gotta do to get myself better? So I start waking up early morning, 6 o'clock, 6:30, like no lie. I'm getting up, shooting shots, like down the street from my house. I'm getting up, shooting shots. It's brick outside, like it's mad cold outside. Dumb days is basically paying off. So it's like as I get shots up and stuff, I'm starting to go to the gyms. I'm probably the last pick. So then I just keep working. So then I'm starting to get like called like probably the third pick or something. So then, as time go on, I'm in the gym, I'm just grinding. Like, I'm like, yo, I know I'm better than this. I know I am. So like, I'm putting in the time, putting in all, like, I'm working out, going like hard. So it's like one time I go to the gym and they I got Bones first. I'm like, yo, so I'm just seeing this is paying off. I'm seeing it paying off. So then like my popularity start rising in the hood and stuff like that inside the state of Delaware. Like I start going up like around the like country and stuff, like mad people starting to know me. It's starting to feel good. So it's just like, it's just all paying off, all the hard work. So now I got this like this city on my back, basically. Everybody believing in me, everybody counting on me to put Delaware on the map. So it just feel good as a junior. It feels great to know that everybody's behind me, the city on my back, putting on for them, giving them a show when I go out to play. On my Instagram popping, all that. Like, it just feel good. Like, just knowing somebody in the crowd, just calling my name, cheering my name on. That's lit, though. It's just a blessing, yo. Because I just know, like, all the hard work from when I was little is paying off. Like, I'm starting to get college offers and all. It just feel good, though. Like,
we got London on the train. Everyone know I've been killed before. I've been bent like a centerfold. I crap with my money, no. Drop that top, get a breather.
So, last year, y'all did great. Number one team in the state. But, I mean, y'all missed what y'all was going after. Talk about that.
Last year, it was a good year. Great year, as a matter of fact. It could have been better, though. We didn't get what we wanted. We were number one going into the tournament. I say we got a little bit cocky a little bit as the season started to get down here. It was a good game in the second round at the bar, though. It was close. Everybody was there. They wanted to see me and Bones play. It was a lot of energy in there. That was my first time there. I ain't the performance that I wanted to do, but hey. Just gonna use that as motivation for this year. This year I'm gonna be different. They ain't gonna be ready for it.
All state was one of the goals last year too.
Yeah.
So what's up with that?
We accomplished some goals last year. All state last year. I won second team all state. We accomplished that goal. But this year I wanna go like first team all state. I wanna be like player of the year. I wanna win a championship. It's things I wanna do so I can scratch off my list so I can like, when I get like to college and stuff, I don't have to worry about like not getting a championship or looking back on those like days or things I could have done better. So I want to leave it out on the floor. I want my teammates to be on one page with me. So like, I'm just doing like little things right now just to like get my teammates on that same page as me. So
Like, when we get to that stage, the Final Four or something, like, we still on that same page. When we get to the championship game, we're still on that same page. So we just win it all. And at the end, it's going to be a great feeling. Like, a great feeling. So right now, we're just grinding. So when that time comes, we're going to be ready.
Yeah. I